Baltimore, Akira, Carolina, New Orleans, and Chicago. Holland down in Philly, Manhattan, Denver. That Tallahassee crowd is deep. They lunching in Vancouver. Desperado shooting. The renegades on the loose. The hyenas looting. Gold out in QC. Who higher than them sparrows? The Furies swooping in divine order for the pharaohs. Indy on the rise. The Sharks about to mash. Gladiators, Knights, and Aztecs about to clash. Welcome to my playoff party. Baby girl, it's a playoff party. The SFL is an all-pro party. They came out to get the playoffs started. Now welcome to my playoff party. Baby girl, it's a playoff party. The SFL is an all-pro party. They came out to get the playoffs started. First and 10, I'm so aggressive. The end zone, the game plan, no pressure. They gotta pay me how they measure me. You know these haters on my back like the referee. You know I'm in it to win it. Game day, I'm about my business, I gotta get it. So I'm all about my ends. And these non-stop wins. They can't touch us, can't touch us. We turning up, only something. You know the D brought the Rockets. Cause we tighter than the Huddles. Welcome to my playoff party. Baby girl, it's a playoff party. The SFL is an all-pro party. They came out to get the playoffs started. Now welcome to my playoff party. Baby girl, it's a playoff party. The SFL is an all-pro party. They came out to get the playoffs started.
Third down is going down. Round the pound, all we gotta air them out. That's why I gotta hit the route. Hit the flat, if I catch it, then I'm out. Fourth and inches, gotta take it. YOLO, just no pump fake. So tighten up and hit the power high.
What a move by Varner. Varner makes an end miss. Shane Varner is going to score. One of the best plays in Varner's illustrious career.
Let me remind folks here, Shane Varner, a 6'6" tight end with this nimble move.
Hart 20, down to the 17-yard line. Best run of the day for Colin Hart. And Sioux Falls has grabbed some momentum off the Nyberg interception. 7:54 to go in the second. Jay Ayala shakes it. Oh, my goodness. Ayala gets away. Jay Ayala on the first play for Tallahassee. It's going to score again. Pass is intercepted by Jeffrey Daggs. And returned up to the 11-yard line. And the Aztecs. Breaks another tackle! Ash Holland, you've got to be kidding me! Big chase, 10-5 touchdown! Oh my
Tonight, Monday night playoff action here in Anchorage, Alaska. The number 8 Sioux Falls Sparrows come in at 7-5, coming off a win in Wild Card Wednesday to take on the number 1 Alaska Storm, who are still undefeated this season. It's Monday, it's SFL playoff action here in Anchorage, Alaska, as the Storm start their title defense in the playoffs. And it all starts on Twitch on SFL Network, presented by APM Music, and we're going to start it right now. Welcome to Anchorage, Alaska. I'm Andy Hamilton, along with Ramos Lynn in the booth and Nathan Blake on stats. It's Anchorage, Alaska. It's 48 degrees and cloudy. The wind is moving 10 miles per hour to the southeast, and we are going to eliminate a football team here tonight and send one through to the semifinals. Andy Hamilton along with Ramos Lynn. Ramos, Sioux Falls 0-2 against Alaska in the regular season. These Western teams are going to clash again tonight, and only one can get the victory.
Yeah, only one can get the victory, and if Sioux Falls wants to win this game, they need to do stuff completely different of what they did in the regular season, because they not only got beat, but they got destroyed both times. And, you know, they're coming into Alaska. this is going to be really, really difficult here for the Sioux Falls Sparrows if they don't change their playbook offensively and defensively dramatically.
Sioux Falls wearing the white uniforms, blue and yellow for South Dakota State. Their alternate uniforms are looking good on the road, and for Alaska, they will receive the ball wearing their blue with dark blue trim, a classic look for the Alaska Storm and Max Paul. Again, Andy Hamilton, Nathan Blake is on stats along with Ramos Lynn. The final quarterfinal game, we have one ticket left to the semifinals and only one of these two teams can punch their ticket tonight. 11 minutes on the clock in the first quarter, ball on the tee for Sioux Falls. Let's go ahead and, as Cam would say, kick it! Return will come out from the 15. It will angle towards the 30 and go down at the 30-yard line, and the Alaska Storm offense will come out. Ramos, they are high-powered and high-flying. They like to throw the ball all around, number one in points per game and number two through the air, and it all starts with number three, Ron Cochran.
Yeah, it does, and this is a team that likes to throw the ball short to set up, you know, and to bring the safety down in the box, and then they just go up top with Robert Maryland, the boys. So I'm expecting a little bit of short passes, and then they will go deep 50 yards.
First play from scrimmage. Cochran has time in the pocket, now pressured, and he is going to get sacked on the first play. Down he goes. It's big number 98 for Sioux Falls. That's Lennox Sanders, who was in the backfield.
Well, that's a way to start the game if you're Sioux Falls. I mean, this is, you know, going to be important if they can put in some pressure on Ron Cochran. And this is a coverage sack, Andy, on this one. I mean, Ron Cochran had time to throw, and nobody was open. Man-to-man coverage on this, and let's see if Sioux Falls corners can hold.
Second and a mile, and they will find Robert Merrill across the middle to the 29. For those of you asking, why is it sunny out? It is 5:26 local time here in Anchorage, Alaska. So the sun is shining, making it a little bit warmer here in the frozen tundra.
And this is a 3rd and 10 here, and this is where you want to be if you're Sioux Falls. I mean, get a stop here, get the ball back, and, you know, get some confidence on defense.
Cochran looking to throw again, fires way down the middle. It's tipped up, still in the air, and incomplete. A nice defensive play by Sioux Falls. Jay Ringgold was all over that one.
And Jay Ringgold and this secondary of Sioux Falls had a terrific game last Wild Card Wednesday against the Las Vegas Fury. They even got a pick six and stuff, and they were able to put in some pressure on the quarterback. And, you know, if they want to do the if they want to win this game, they have to do the same thing with Alaska. Put some pressure on Rock Cochran, cover the receivers extremely well, because this is a team in Alaska that doesn't run the ball too much. They have a really good fullback, but I think that their priority is to stop the pass.
First drive was a success for Sioux Falls. They will get the punt. We'll bring you into the broadcast booth. Andy Hamilton along with Ramos Lynn. I am suited out, ready for the playoffs. Ramos, it's the best time of the year, as you know, coming off of last night's win in overtime. What a game.
Man, it was such a thrilling matchup. And really, all the games between Baltimore and Mexico City / Santa Fe Gorillas are always like this, honestly. Let's see if we can have a similar game tonight.
I sure hope so. Tyree will throw on first down. Nice check down out of the backfield to the rookie, Colin Hart. And he is wrapped up nearly immediately. That was DJ Majesty, his first season with the Alaska Storm, third season in the league altogether, coming over from Houston in the offseason.
Yeah, and DJ Majesty, for the first time in his career, got a couple sacks. I mean, he came into this season with zero sacks. And so far, he has got a couple in the year. So it's going to be important to see if he can also put some pressure on the QB.
Tyree to throw again. Stands in the pocket and delivers. Oh, it's incomplete at the last minute. Sean Harrelson was the one who was the intended receiver at the 32. It'll be 3rd and 10. Still no yards game for this Sioux Falls offense.
And it's going to be super important for these two teams to win field position, it seems, because, I mean, I'm expecting a lot of fireworks, but it seems that this has been a game where, well, at least in this first two drives, where the defenses are really coming in strong.
Shotgun look, four receivers spread out on both sides. High snap, Tyree fires short. That is incomplete. Alaska doesn't give up a yard on the first drive. He was trying to hit James, the fourth receiver, and it did not work. And Sioux Falls will have to call on Moholt to punt it away. So two opening punts. We're looking like a defensive battle here, Ramos.
Yeah, I mean, it does seem so far. I mean, we've had a playoffs with a lot of points, but so far it seems that Sioux Falls and Alaska are into a defensive slugfest. I mean, this is two teams that defensively, historically, are extremely, extremely good. And maybe by the third quarter, fourth quarter, we will see a team or a pair of teams which, you know, kind of are adjusting to the defensive tendencies and kind of spreading the game around.
That was a fair catch. So Ron Cochran will come back out onto the field. Ramos, a nice statistic for you. Ron Cochran, for every 16 throws he has in the league this year, one of them goes for a touchdown. So absolutely unbelievable numbers from Ron Cochran. One of his best seasons here in Alaska. And another member of this Storm offense is having a career year. We'll get to that in a minute. Cochran firing deep left side. Caught! Oh! Down the sideline. How's he not out of bounds? Now he is. Optimus Climb, hold that in. They're going to have to look at that because his foot was right on that sideline, tightroping it.
Wow, and see, told you. I mean, this is a team that, you know, throws the ball short, and, you know, doesn't seem that it's going to be a big threat. And then all of a sudden, 40 yards down the field, you see number 88. Not great coverage on that one. It seems like, you know, they were not expecting the deep throw. Probably he was expecting, like, an out route or something, like a deep out. And Sioux Falls is challenging.
There's the challenge.
I think this is a catch and out of bounds, obviously.
Well, I'm going to disagree with you, Ramos. I thought he was real close. I didn't see exactly when he caught it where his foot was, but they'll look at it. But before we get to that, Optimus Klein was the one who I was highlighting. Also having a career year, 9 touchdowns. That's the most in his career, his best season here in Alaska. Nice catch there, but the question is, was he in bounds? Ref 62 will come out from the booth and give us the answer. So they're going to stay. He's out of bounds. Sioux Falls will not be charged with the timeout. The question is, was he out before the catch? No, they're going to give him the catch. It'll be first down for Alaska. So some relief out of the Storm as they will pick up the first down. A nice grab by Optimus Klein. And good luck to Nathan Blake on figuring out the stats on that.
Yeah, I agree. And all of a sudden, Alaska, they have a contracted kicker, so they're in field goal range.
Split back formation for Ron Cochran from the 33. He will throw again. Slant route caught. Optimus Klein, another 9 yards for him, and he stayed inbounds that time right in front of A.J. Levy in the Sioux Falls Sparrows defense.
You know, and this is something that they love to do, and that's why Ron Cochran is so effective. They are able to put it, the wide receiver, in positions where they can get open in short patterns. You know, it's not very complicated short patterns. Look at that.
Firing down the middle, caught for the goal line. No, Optimus Klein's a yard short, and he is off to a superb start. 3 catches, 65 yards for Optimus Klein. He is the go-to for Ron Cochran so far in this one.
Yeah, and it's been for a few seasons now, obviously the number one wide receiver on the Alaska Storm, and this is why they have a fullback here, Andy. You know, they are in first and goal, the ball at the one, and this screams I'm going to give the ball to Jason Williams.
Williams.
Oh, he's not even on the field, actually.
Yeah, okay. There you go. I was going to say he has 4.4 yards per carry. This 1 yard should be easy for him, but he's not there. Nordellis is out of the backfield. Cochran to throw. Checks down to Nordellis. Turns. He can't stay in bounds. He'll go out at the 1. Second and goal. Sioux Falls gets a break there. That was dangerous.
Yeah, it was. And I like the play call. I think that the play call was okay. I mean, obviously, if you're Sioux Falls, looking at the power that this Alaska offense can bring, you want to stack the box, but you go to the outside, and I think it's a good idea. Now, look at that. I mean, there's nobody. I mean, there's 4 guys, but it's a very spread defense. Let's see if they run it here.
Split backs. Cochran to throw. High snap. Sioux Falls bringing late pressure, and they get to Ron Cochran and sack him. Back at the 8. It's a nice job defensively from Tyrone Black, who kept the motor going and got to Ron Cochran in the backfield.
Wow, and this is, again, another coverage sack. Nobody was open, and I'm really surprised by the play call of Alaska here. I mean, I know that they're a passing team, but they do have Jason Williams, the fullback, on their roster, and he's been borderline unstoppable on the, you know, goal line and third and inches and stuff. So, you know, I'm surprised that they didn't even put him on the field as a decoy or something. And just because, he, you know, it's 3rd and goal at the 8, they have to throw it again.
3rd and goal. Sioux Falls trying to get the goal line stand. Cochran to throw. Fires corner out. Wide open. Got it. Unbelievable catch. Robert Merrill hauls it in and taps the toes. Touchdown, Alaska.
And if you're, I mean, I don't want to be harsh, but if you're Sioux Falls, I mean, how can you let that happen? I mean, it's like the only thing that you needed to cover was the end zone. Look at that. I mean, if they throw the ball short and they have to fight for the end zone, okay. But, you know, if I'm Sioux Falls, I'm just putting everything back in the paint and just, hey, I mean, make you know, everything in front of you and just make the tackle before they can get in. And, you know, it was one-on-one coverage. And not only that, but it seems like a busted coverage or something.
Ron Cochran, opening drive, or second drive, excuse me, 6 of 7 for 80 yards and a touchdown with a rating of 153.87. Kick from Brad Breschett is good. It is 7-0 Alaska. We're going to take a break and be right back on the SFL Network, brought to you by APM Music.
The Simulation Football League is presented by APM Music and is the official theme music provider of the SFL. Listen to their Champions Will Rise soundtrack at apmmusic.com today and search through thousands of tracks to boost the quality of your stream just like us. APM Music, production music library and custom music house.
A.J. Levy on the return, his sixth season in a Sioux Falls Sparrow uniform. Ramos, one other man, came into the Sioux Falls Sparrows team and sticks with it through here along with A.J. Levy. That is Julian Tyree, and he is now under center, his sixth season, all with Sioux Falls. Two great cornerstones of this Sparrows offense. Hand off to the rookie, Hart off the right side. He picks up four. Nice carry to the 25 to start this drive off.
As you say, you know, Julian Tyree is a future Hall of Famer. We have future Hall of Famers all over the field. Alex Dominguez, a future Hall of Famer. We have Julian Tyree, who is a Hall of Famer, future Hall of Famer. We have Optimus Klein, future Hall of Famer. I mean, we do have a lot of stars. A.J. Levy, you mentioned it. So we have a lot of stars on the football field tonight.
No doubt. We'll get to the offense here in a minute. Tyree, quick throw. Nice catch. A.J. Warren under pressure makes the grab at the 36.
And, well, you know, sorry for interrupting you. Doing something similar, Sioux Falls as Alaska, you know, that slant route, you know, on the spread formations, and, you know, it was dangerous. That could have been intercepted, but luckily for Julian Tyree and the Sioux Falls Sparrows, he was not.
Tyree to throw again under a little bit of pressure now. Fires deep down the right side. Hold in! Nice grab there for Sioux Falls. Craig Hearn, another rookie getting involved. The tight end makes the grab on the corner route.
And that's a beautiful throw by Julian Tyree, probably the best throw we've seen all night for either team. Man-on-man coverage, and DJ Majesty is on the tight end. And, you know, basically that's what you want sometimes, you know, because of size. DJ Majesty is a quick guy. So I don't blame the matchup, but that's just a beautiful throw by the future Hall of Famer.
Great throw by Tyree. Let's go through the Sioux Falls offense right quick. Tyree, the quarterback. Colin Hart, a rookie running back. Craig Hearn there, the rookie tight end, along with Riley Porter, the rookie wide receiver on the outside, as Hart gets another yard there. And then the two veteran receivers are A.J. Warren. This is his second season, both with Sioux Falls. And Sean Harrelson, a little bit of an SFL journeyman, his second season with Sioux Falls, fifth overall, coming over from Carolina. So lots of weapons for Tyree, a few rookies, a few veterans. He's going to fire here and nearly threw an interception. Alaska was all over that one, almost took it away. It was Chris Mack.
Yeah, that was so dangerous. And I think that on 3rd and 9, you're kind of still in field goal range and you don't want to throw a pick. You want to come up with some points. I might actually just go ahead and dump it off to Colin Hart, like on a screen pass, and see if he can make something out of a 3rd down and 9, because this secondary is very dangerous.
Three receivers split out now. 7-0 Alaska, 3rd and 9. Tyree fires down the middle, and that one was simply a mirror of the play before. Chris Mack has now had two chances for a pick. Couldn't get either of them.
Yeah, that seemed like a rewind of the same exact play almost. Even the same guy on the same kind of interception attempt. And it couldn't happen. So maybe the wind is blowing hard against the punter, because they are trying to punt and instead of making a 49-yard attempt.
Wind is going southeast. 10 miles per hour is nothing to scoff at. So Sioux Falls try and flip the field here. This one will be fair caught. Oh, no, excuse me. It was a return. And they will get to the 15. A dangerous grab there for Alaska. I'm sure Mighty was a little concerned there when the fair catch wasn't waved for.
Yeah, and now it's the opportunity for Alaska to start, you know, gassing this Sioux Falls defense. If Alaska can keep the time of possession up on their favor, it's going to be super important at home. So they don't have, as far as a running back goes, their running game to do so, but they do have Jason Williams, who's not on the field again. I'm surprised about that.
Cochran to throw. Out route. That is collected and moved to the 21. Nice grab there by Jeff Como, his second season with Alaska. Well, I tell you what, Ramos, if there's one thing that'll get the Twitch chat going, and we haven't found it so far, but it's simply put on a suit, and then everyone in the Twitch chat just goes crazy.
Yeah, and I cannot blame Alaska not going fullback much, because Sioux Falls historically has great linebacker. Look at that.
Well, they went fullback there, and it did not pay off for them. Sioux Falls was all over that one. That was number 93, Johnny Summers, the defensive tackle, who made Jason Williams wish it was spring and fall there. No, no good on that one? All right, I'll try again. You only get so many seasons jokes. Cochran to throw. Nice play action, and he finds his man across the middle. That's Robert Merrill. Ramos, Alaska, the number one team in third down efficiency with 68% of their third down passes on offense getting the first down. They show just there why they are the number one team with a little play action.
And it really starts right there with the offensive line. That's a play action play, slow developing, and if you need to have the protection on your offensive line to make that play work. You know, you cannot have a defensive tackle breathing on your neck 1 second after the snap. You know, you have to get some protection by your offensive line, and it happened that time.
Cochran in the shotgun, now two backs, three receivers split out. He gives off the right-hand side. That was to Jason Williams, and that was a long developing play there. It only gets one.
Yeah, and it's going to be... It's going to be super important for Sioux Falls to keep Alaska on second and nine, third and nine, third and eight, because as you said, you know, they're super efficient on third downs, so they need to keep Alaska as far as they can on those third downs.
Cochran, short drop, fires a wobbler. That is complete for a first down right in front of a man who's been all over the field, Alex Parker. We haven't mentioned him yet, but that is, I think, his third tackle in a row for the fourth-year man, all with Sioux Falls. Again, a lot of veteran players here on Sioux Falls have a lot of dedication sticking with the Sparrows.
Yeah, this is a very loyal team. You know, A.J. Levy has been here for a while, Julian Tyree, etc.
Cochran fires out route. That is complete again. Another completion for Ron Cochran. Jeff Como hauls that one into the 41.
And now they're in Sioux Falls territory, and Alaska slowly but surely really starting to click on offense. You know, the first drive, they got sacked on the first play, and since then, Ron Cochran has had pretty much all day to throw. Has been sacked twice so far in this first quarter. One when they were close to scoring range, but overall, they've had a lot of protection. Oh,
clobbered up the middle. They were trying to sneak one through with Jason Williams. And Nick Fargo, the former Carolina Skyhawk, says, no, not today.
Yeah, not today. And, you know, maybe that's why they are not using the fullback too much on the inside, because it's a very strong core of linebackers that this Sioux Falls team has.
Two running backs split out here for this third and one. The handoff. Did he get there? No. Jason Williams is an inch short. Nice play there from the Sioux Falls defensive line. Johnny Summers again was all over him.
And in fourth and inches, you have a decision to make. Honestly, if I'm Alaska, I'm going for it. I mean, well, the defense is playing lights out. I will honestly go for it.
The offense is on the field, but they got them all spread out. 3-2 look out of the Sparrows. One back in the backfield with Cochran. He's taking his time, trying to pull him off on the hard count. Now snaps it. Cochran stands, delivers a short ball, and Stanley Nordellis is dropped. Nice defensive play there by Nick Fargo, who's all over it again. And the ball is turned over, and Sioux Falls takes it away.
Wow, what a play by Sioux Falls. I don't blame the play call of going for it. I actually suggest it because your offense is on a roll. Your defense is playing really strong. So I honestly suggest it. But what a tackle by the former Pro Bowler. Last season, Nick Fargo was in the Pro Bowl. And, you know, open field, that's not an easy tackle to make because if you don't make it, you have the pressure that if you don't make it, that's a first down. So he wraps him up. He puts him on the ground. And Sioux Falls has the ball.
Fargo is in North Dakota. Sioux Falls plays in South Dakota, but here in Alaska, they have the ball back. Tyree, a quick out route there, caught and hauled in. Moving upfield was A.J. Warren, who's able to get 7 out of that reception.
And, you know, this is something that Julian Tyree has to do. I mean, he has to be on a rhythm, has to connect some throws, even if it's just dump-offs and screen passes. You know, he needs to get, you know, have that kind of confidence on himself. It's like, hey, I can connect 8 out of 10 passes completed. So I think they need to start throwing the ball short.
4 of 8 is Tyree so far, 49 yards. He'll throw again. Nice check down here to Hart. Hart has a blocker and some room, and Hart finds his way to the 45 before Alaska's defense and Ryan Tobin bring him down there.
And, you know, Colin Hart, one of the strongest running backs in the SFL to tackle this season. You know, when he's in the open field, he's really dangerous. So really good tackle on the outside by the defensive back.
23 seconds and ticking. Sioux Falls will throw again. Pressure coming, and Tyree took too long, and he pays the price. Coming in to make the play for Alaska was number 78. That's Gerald Thomas, the defensive end, 6'3", 295 pounds, rushing at you.
Yeah, it's not easy. I mean, it's not easy to go against this Alaska defense.
Not at all. 7-0. Alaska on top. That's the end of the first quarter. It's the SFL Network brought to you by APM Music, live on Twitch. Andy Hamilton and Ramos Lynn here with you, along with Nathan Blake on stats. Sioux Falls in Alaska, the last quarterfinal matchup of this SFL season. 2nd and 14, and boy, talk about an exotic formation, Ramos. 3 backs in the backfield on 2nd and a mile. They will give to Hart off the left side, and he is stood up and will lose a yard. Nice play there by Evan Carroll, the cornerback on the pursuit, who was in there immediately, along with number 52, Andrew Francis.
Yeah, it's something that Alaska does very well. I mean, they say speed kills, and this Alaska defense has probably the fastest in the league. You know, they have a lot of secondary players. They have a defensive tackle who is really fast in Alex Dominguez.
Tyree fires. It's caught, but it's short of the sticks. Still a grab for Riley Porter. I believe that is his 2nd grab of the night. And Sioux Falls will punt again here, stalling out Alaska's defense, getting another stop.
And again, you know, they were able to stop him before field goal range. They are about 12 yards away from field goal, maybe 10 yards because the wind is now on Sioux Falls' side. About 10 yards away from field goal range, and another big-time stop for this Storm.
Kick is away and into the end zone. No good there. That was a nicely punted ball, plenty of power on it, but not nearly enough finesse.
No, I mean, probably, you know, when you kick to one side and the wind is like strong against you, you get used to it. So you tend to go, when you go to the other side, you tend to kick the ball a little bit too hard.
Now Cochran to throw again, checks down. That is complete to Stanley Nordellis out of the backfield. A look at the quarterback comparison so far. Ron Cochran doing a solid job. Tyree has not turned the ball over yet, which is a good job here as these two teams are looking to get things going. Only 7-0 here, still a one-possession game.
Interesting defensive formation here for Sioux Falls.
Hand off, off the right-hand side. Puts one man to the ground. That's a nice carry for a first down there by the fullback, Jason Williams, the rookie. One of the only rookies on this Alaska team.
Wow, and you know, this is something that Alaska does very well, and you know, it's changing the pace of the game. You know, first it was like deep throws and everything, and now they go with a little bit of run. They go play action. So they really keep a defense on their heels.
Cochran to throw, now wants it all going deep, picked off, coming the other way, it's A.J. Levy, that veteran for Sioux Falls has the pick, and he's down to the Alaska 38 turnover.
Well, that's, I mean, reading this one all the way, running the route for the offensive player, and, you know, this is what you get when you have a defensive player who's been in the league for about 6 or 7 seasons already. And you get that veteran presence that, you know what's coming, especially when you have faced Alaska many times in your career.
4 receivers split out. We already talked about the Sparrows. 0-2 versus Alaska so far this year, trying to change it. And Big Sexy has a sack. Alex Dominguez, that's his 39th of the season. 39 and a half sacks now. 46 tackles for loss. This man is playing at an all-time pro, all Hall of Fame level.
You know, he really is. I mean, it's probably the most impressive, you know, season by one player in league history, alongside Rocco Marconi season 4, maybe.
Undoubtedly. Flip out to Hart. Hart gains those yards back, so it'll be 3rd and 10 for Tyree, and they are still out of field goal range, trying to get on the board. This is something they've struggled with when they play Alaska in the past. They've struggled to just get on the board even, Ramos.
Yeah, they really have. And, you know, this is a Sioux Falls team that it's really hard to know what you're going to get week to week. You know, you might get the Sioux Falls team that can score 35 points on you. You might get the Sioux Falls team that cannot get a first down, but their defense is playing really good. So it's really, really hard to know.
Tyree caught A.J. Warren down to the 12. An unbelievable throw and catch. Put it down to the 12. That is a red zone trip for Sioux Falls and an amazing throw from Tyree.
That's an unbelievable throw, and that's a really poor play by the safety. I mean, I don't want to blame him. He was close on the play, but you need to at least tip that ball away. I mean, you're playing center fielder. That's your job, and you didn't do it.
Stuffed run. They were looking for Colin Hart out of the backfield. Talking, Ramos, about the playoffs here so far. This is the last quarterfinal game. These teams are trying to punch their ticket into the semifinals. The winner of this game will take on the number 4 Houston Hyenas. If Alaska were to win, they would be here at the I. If Sioux Falls would win, they would travel to Houston. So lots of interesting storylines here as we move into the semifinals. Hart is stuffed again. It'll be 3rd and 15 from the 16, so they need to get down to the 1 if they want the first down.
Yep. And it comes back to the same thing that I was saying. You know, honestly, I'm playing this conservative. I'm just checking it down because, you know, Alaska's so opportunistic. I mean, at any point I can get an interception, so I will just go ahead and dump it short.
Tyree does dump it. That is caught to the 5. A.J. Warren again on the reception. He has been having a day so far. That's his 4th catch. Over 50 yards for him so far. They will bring out Sammy Prefontaine to try and put points on the board, and I think this is the right move.
That most definitely. I mean, you need to get some points. I mean, you cannot come in, you know, get to the 5-yard line after an interception and come away with 0. I mean, you need to kick a field goal, get some points, and just, you know, play some more defense, try to get the ball back.
Kick is up, and it is through 3-7. The Sparrows cut the lead down to 4. We'll step aside and be right back on the SFL Network, brought to you by APM Music.
Join the world's fastest-growing sim football community by jumping onto our Discord server. Use the Discord command in chat to keep up with schedules, news, notes, announcements, and polls. Jump off the sidelines and into the action here where we're loading legends at the SFL.
Hey
Nice return there by Alaska out to the 30, but Sioux Falls and A.J. Levy sniffed out the return. It was looking dangerous for a minute. I almost had to pause the ad, but he was brought down, and they'll start their drive at the 30 here, Alaska, with a slightly smaller lead. Three receivers split to the bottom of your screen. No one at the top. Cochran will throw. Fires quickly to the right side. It's taken away. Sioux Falls has the ball right back. Immediately, it's the rookie, Andrew Nyberg. He was a star in last week's game on Wild Card Wednesday with a pick six, I believe. And he has an interception there and gets the ball back.
Yeah, correct. He had an interception for a pick six that really, really, really put the defensive effort of Sioux Falls on a high note at the end of the game, and now they take it away again. Sioux Falls is really, really, really taking the momentum in this football game. Now they need to score some points. If they get six interceptions, it doesn't matter if they cannot come away with some points. They need to score here again, at least another 3 points.
Very true. Handoff, Hart, into the open field. Are they going to catch him? 20, 15, 10, 5, no! Sioux Falls take the lead! Unbelievable touchdown by Colin Hart!
Wow, what a play to get in the paint. Look at the offensive line, Andy. Look at the fullback right there. In the offensive line, look at the guard. The fullback puts a player on his back. I don't know who that was. I mean, he ran him over, so I didn't even catch the number. DJ Majesty, look at that.
Yeah, and that's no jump at linebacker either.
What a play by the offensive line.
Great job by Sioux Falls taking that interception and wasting no time getting in the end zone. They will, try and add the extra point to make it a 3-point lead. And the chat's talking about why are people surprised that Sioux Falls is playing this well? Well, I'll be honest, Ramos. They lost their Week 13 game to a team that is not even in these playoffs. So an unbelievable scenes from Sioux Falls to not only do what they did last time out against Las Vegas, but to come on the short week against the defending champs and do what they're doing so far. I mean, there's a lot of game to be played, but it's impressive.
No, it's super impressive. I mean, they started losing this game 7-0, and it's been a 10-point run since, in just about 5 minutes or so. So it's not even that, like 2 minutes. So it's really impressive what Sioux Falls is doing as far as, you know, fixing their football defense. They got a big goal, and now they get two interceptions back-to-back.
Alaska will come back out onto the field. Ramos, let's talk quickly a little bit more about the playoffs here. The Eastern Conference in the playoffs is 1-4 so far through Wild Card Wednesday in the quarterfinals. The Western Conference is 2-1. Obviously, they will be 3-2 no matter what happens in this game here. The South is 2-0 with Houston and Tallahassee improving. So lots to be still had. The Eastern Conference is out. It's the West and the South throughout the rest of the playoffs. Oh, hell in the world! Did Optimus Klein haul that one in? No way!
Wow. I mean, that's why they're in the playoffs, right? I mean, we've seen some incredible plays, incredible throws, great runs, great job by the offensive line. Alex Dominguez getting in the backfield and you know, almost a kick return for a touchdown. I mean, this is why these teams are here in the playoffs. Alaska, the defending champion, and Sioux Falls, always a contender for the championship.
Sioux Falls here to play some press coverage. They will bump at the line. Hand off there to the back man. I believe that's Jason Williams, and it is. He will get stuffed at the 33. Now a 3rd-and-3, Ramos, for the best third down conversion team in the SFL coming into the playoffs.
Yeah, and you know, the 3rd-and-3, this is very, very doable here for the Alaska Storm. And this is not a 3rd-and-long. They have the pieces to do it. And, you know, look at the players that I put in the box.
Cochran to throw wide open across the middle. That might be the easiest third down conversion you see in these SFL playoffs. Jason Julian, the 6'6 tight end, found himself with so much space, he thought he had just bought an island in the Caribbean.
Yeah, and you know, everybody in Sioux Falls was playing outside. And, you know, Alaska did what they needed to do. It was just a quick slant route. And he was completely wide open.
There, a look at Ron Cochran's numbers. And the interceptions are not something that he is you know, been impervious to throughout this season. So far, as we've seen tonight, he's already thrown two. So it'll be interesting to see how this Sioux Falls secondary deals with that. The handoff here is to Jason Williams, and he's got a first down to the 47.
You know, this is why he's so dangerous on the backfield, and this is why you cannot put all your defenders back, like, to cover the pass at all times. You need to cover number 34 when he's on the field. Look at that. He puts a strong safety on his back, and, you know, it's basically the same size.
Yeah.
From A.J. Levy to Jason Williams. Just Jason Williams with a full head of steam and gets the job done.
And it's really a hard offense to defend considering the way they throw and run the ball. This one tipped up. Oh, dangerous pass. Incomplete. He was trying to find Jeff Como across the middle, and there was a whole flock of sparrows in the middle there.
Yeah, it was. And, you know, you have a spread offense right there where, you know, you kind of want to have some crossing routes maybe to confuse the defense because they are playing a man-to-man. There's a crossing route, but a great job by the defender right there, Sen Osika, who was a star, a contracted player, Sioux Falls, a few seasons back. Now he's taking a lesser role with the additions of Jay Ringel and whatnot, but he's still a really, really good corner.
Yeah, the Sparrows not only keeping these star players here, but keeping the players who were stars and moving them down to non-contract roles. So a nice job by Jason McGee and A.J. Levy to move those players and get that roster set. Cochran now will fire out of the backfield to Nordellis. Nordellis will pick up 5 to the 42, and it'll be 3rd and 5, a little under, 4 minutes to play here in the first half of play. They find themselves down by 3.
With a 3rd and 5 now, the ball at the 42. They need to make a stop, Sioux Falls does, to retain this momentum. As far as Alaska goes, they need to get the first down to get momentum at home and try to score before the half.
Cochran fires. Oh, it was dropped. Oh. Optimus Klein had a touchdown. I was practically writing it on my score sheet, and he could not hold on to the ball, which makes no sense, Ramos, because he pulled a rabbit out of his hat on the last drive and made a catch that we never would have seen.
And it happens sometimes. You know, those wide receivers, they are so wide open that they just lose concentration, and that's what happened. The defender got lost in the play. He played the ball extremely bad, and Optimus Klein was wide open to take it to the end zone. And, you know, he was so wide open that he just got some jitters, or I don't know what happened, but maybe the playoff nerves, something. But that's such a tough break for Alaska and could decide the game.
Punt down, and it will be down and into the end zone. Alaska cannot keep it out, so Sioux Falls will start this drive at the 20. All 3 timeouts, 3:16 left to go, and Julian Tyree, 9 of 13, 104 yards. Still clean, no touchdowns, but no picks either. It's really been Colin Hart who's been making damage. He has 9 touches for 52 yards and a touchdown, averaging 6.8 yards per carry. Tyree to throw here, moves in the pocket, hit, floats one, and it's incomplete. Big Sexy was bearing down on him, and he just got it away.
You know, when you have a guy like that, Big Sexy, you need to get rid of the football. And, you know, he almost got a completion. It was a dangerous throw, but he almost got the completion. So I can live with that.
It wasn't
because
a bad throw at all.
Yeah, I mean, I can live with it because there was 2 offensive players of Sioux Falls in the facility, so that could have been completed.
Yeah, for sure. Heavy formation here out of Sioux Falls. Time is stopped. Now they will throw. Tyree checks it down to Hart with a blocker in front of him. Hart down the right-hand sideline, breaks the tackle, and skips out of bounds at the 34. A first down right in front of head coach Jason McGee.
And it's a very extremely important that you get a first down here. Colin Hart completely open in the open field, and the defender cannot make the stop before the first down marker. So, I mean, Sioux Falls really has taken this second quarter. Alaska in the first quarter seems to have all the momentum, but now Sioux Falls seems that they have found a way to move the ball against this Alaska defense, and they've been very good on the defensive side as well.
Now a sack. He couldn't avoid that one. Alex Dominguez was all over him like icing on a cake.
Yeah, and it's just about time for Alex Dominguez to get on those plays. You know, it's when you have those 2-3-step drops, you need to get the ball, you know, rid of the ball quickly. Even if it's a check down, throw it out of bounds, do something. I mean, you cannot pat the ball 2-3 seconds when you're so close to the line of scrimmage.
Hand off here to Hart on second and a mile, and he is stuffed. Alaska now is smelling blood in the water. Evan Carroll and DJ Majesty put the hit on him, and it'll be third and 13. It's time to throw, and the pressure will be on Tyree.
It is, and, you know, it makes you wonder. Well, right now they're going empty side. I was going to say, it makes you wonder, you know, throw a screen, because it seems that that's the thing that is working for you to get some big yards, but...
Tyree takes the safe check down there, finds Craig Hearn, who's been the safety blanket for Tyree so far. Warren has kind of been the big play guy, and Craig Hearn has been the safety blanket. 2 minute warning here in Alaska. They're about to get the ball back. It's 10-7. We got a tight one so far. It's the SFL playoffs, hashtag SFL playoffs, brought to you by APM Music. Andy Hamilton and Ramos Lynn here, Anchorage, Alaska. It's 48 degrees and cloudy. Winds moving 10 miles per hour southeast. We're in the eye of the storm. And so far, the storm has seemed pretty tame so far. Two interceptions for Ron Cochran. If you're just tuning in, Sioux Falls has gotten off to a hot start. But Alaska's about to get the ball back here. 2 minute offense for Ron Cochran. Return will come out, and they will start at the 26.
Now, if you're Alaska, what do you do? I mean, do you want to throw the ball? Because, I mean, you've got it intercepted two times already, so you don't want to put the ball in your own territory in a dangerous situation. But at the same time, 152, that's more than enough time with three timeouts to move the ball down a field and get a score. So do you play this conservative, or you want to throw the ball here?
I'd go for it, Riverboat Ron. Instead, they'll hand off on the first play to Jason Williams. Maybe just get the clock rolling. Williams has been shut down so far, 2.8 yards per carry. And for Sioux Falls, they have really profited off of the turnovers of Ron Cochran. So maybe Max Paul wants to get into the locker room and have a talk with his boys and protect Ron Cochran here.
Yeah, I might agree with that. And you know, if you're Sioux Falls, if you, I mean, if you get a third and eight or something, let's see.
Well, third and seven, that's a little bit better there. Clock is rolling. I'm surprised Sioux Falls hasn't taken a timeout.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's what I was saying. You know, if you can get a third down on more than 5 yards, I will say Sioux Falls could call a timeout and try to get a score on their own.
10-7 game here. Sioux Falls will get the kick after the half if you're just tuning in. Now five wide for Ron Cochran. 3-2 look out of Sioux Falls. They'll bring an extra blitzer. Cochran fires. Caught. First down. No team in the SFL does it better than Alaska.
Wow. And now they're going to hurry up. And you know, deservingly. So, I mean, it's three timeouts. Still 38 seconds go.
Cochran fires, complete down to the 37, and now a timeout out of Alaska. And I'll remind you, Ramos, and I'm sure you don't need reminding, they do have the star kicker.
They do. I mean, they are going to be on the wrong side of the wind. However, they still have a lot of time to move the ball, and they still have a really, really good kicker. So even though the wind is against them, if you do get to the maybe 32-yard line, a 50-yard attempt, 33-yard line, this is maybe doable.
First and 10 from the 37, 34 seconds to go, two timeouts for the Storm. Cochran fires across the middle, complete. That'll be a first down to the 26, and they will burn their second timeout. Jeff Como all over.
And this is going to be now for sure field goal range for the Alaska Storm with 29 seconds to go. And you were right. I mean, I was saying, you know, do you want risk it? What do you do? And they did. And now they will potentially come away with some points.
First and 10, Riverboat Ron under center. All three receivers are on the field, two backs. Cochran to throw, stands in the pocket, delivers out of the backfield to Nordellis, or is that Williams? Either way, it'll be a 5-yard pickup. Clock will roll, and they're not going to burn that timeout. Williams only got to the 22. Cochran firing again, complete to Julian across the middle. He'll get to the 11, and now the timeout is called with 8 seconds to go. That's a lot of time there, Ramos, and we've seen return men feast off of less time, so interesting to see here if they kick the field goal.
Yeah, they have to kick the field goal. I mean, they have no timeout, so you cannot risk a sack or a tackle in bounds or something even worse. I mean, you know, an interception, something. So you have to kick the field goal and you know, tie this game up.
From the 11, it will be a 28-yarder. 8 seconds to go. Brechit's kick is up, and it is good from 27. Tie ball game, 10-all. 5 seconds left, and it'll be A.J. Levy who will have a chance to return it.
You know, and this is what, you know, I was thinking, you know, with 8 seconds, I mean, do you want to call a timeout with 8 seconds or with 3 seconds, right?
Right, so, let it run down, in my opinion.
Yeah.
You can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, as well as Instagram at SimulationFL. SimulationFL.net. If you're new, make sure you get involved. Stay up to date as the playoffs roll on. A.J. Levy rolls on a spin. Oh, a juke. He got to the outside. 1 second left. We're almost just enough time for the craziest play we've ever seen, right?
Yeah. I think that this is going to be the quick handoff to Colin Hart and take it to the half. And if you're Sioux Falls, you really have to be content with this first half. Going on the road, having the opposing team score first, and taking this 10-10 to the half, I think it has to be a victory for your team.
Last play of the half, Tyree across the middle. That is a completion to the 39. It's a nice grab there for number 88, Craig Hearn, who makes another grab today. That is his third of the day. But alas, it will take us to the halftime break. 10-all, a shocker. The Sparrows sticking with the Alaska Storm through the first half. Andy Hamilton and Ramos Lim will be back after the halftime break from Anchorage, Alaska.
APM Music is the official theme music provider of the SFL. Listen to their Champions Will Rise soundtrack at apmmusic.com and visit their all-new eSports landing page to find the best highlight music, heroic action, and epic sounds to boost the quality of your eSports stream just like us. Log on to form.apmmusic.com/eSports for more information. APM Music, production music library, and custom music house.
Back here in Anchorage, Alaska, we'll get to some chat shout-outs after the kickoff here, so make sure you make yourself known. Andy Hamilton along with Ramos Lynn. Kick it, we're underway for the second half. Sparrows will return. It's A.J. Levy out of his own end zone and across the 20 to the 22. Ramos, the first half was pretty much a back-and-forth battle. The momentum swung Sioux Falls' way. They capitalized. We're up by three, but Alaska at the last second drives into field goal range and knots it up.
Yeah, and, you know, if you're Sioux Falls, you get the ball again to start this third quarter, and you want to put in a solid drive together, not trying to get overly aggressive, I think, in the first three or four plays. Just try to control the ball and the pace of this third quarter.
Colin Hart will get stuffed at the line. Majesty was all over that one. Let's get to the chats. Denver Nightwings, Optimus Climb, YouTube, Jason 1347, Ram Voice donating 400 bits. We love to see that. PGTUKOKL, Optimus Klein, Ethan Kai, Oofish, as well as DR Sim J Ringgold. I saw Dwayne Schindler earlier. Obviously, Cameron Irvine's here. AJ Today Jackson, Attila Y2K, and Mendy Moore. Colin Hart off the right side as a first down and more. He's all the way down to the 39.
What a run right there by Colin Hart, and a great job again by the offense. Great speed on the outside by the running back number 22, going to the outside and outrunning everybody. And, you know, look at that, you know, just a pack of Alaska Storm players chasing him from behind. DJ Majesty at the end of the play makes the tackle.
10 minutes to go here in the third, a 10-10 ball game. Tens all around, and it's first and 10, believe it or not, Ramos. Julian Tyree pumps once, had sexy all over his back, and Colin Hart is into the open field again. This man is electric, and he's down to the 40.
Great job on the outside again by the offensive line. Look at that, number 75 and 73 right there, doing a curtain of blocking right there. And everybody picks up a block, and that springs Colin Hart for another big-time game.
I saw AJ pick six in the chat. That's AJ Levy. Had the chance to meet him and Max Paul at the SFL convention in the offseason. We're hoping to possibly do another one in the next upcoming season. The question is, who will be raising the trophy? It was Max Paul last season, but he might be knocked out here if the Sparrows can get something going, but that is not the way to do it. Big Sexy can sack you, but he can also bat the ball down if you're trying to check down.
Definitely, and you know, if you are Sioux Falls, maybe you want to keep the ball to the outsides and avoid number 69, right? So you want to dump it to the outsides, running to the outsides. And that's what has worked for Sioux Falls. You know, that one touchdown that they had was running to the outside. So maybe you want to keep the ball going to the edges.
Second and 10, handoff Hart. And oh, DJ Majesty is all over that one. That man has been everywhere tonight. And Colin Hart feels the pain at the 41. It'll be third and 11.
And it's only been that 42-yard gain on the touchdown. Other than that, DJ Majesty, Alex Dominguez, those boys have had their number. And now they go in an all wide receiver and tight end set. There is no running back, so no Colin Hart. Maybe a pass to the inside be the good idea here.
Alaska brings four. The pass was to the inside, and DJ Majesty was all over it again. They're teaching him something in Houston because he brought it here to Alaska as well. Fourth and 11. The Sparrows drive stalls out at the 41. They will have to kick.
Yeah, and, you know, what a great stop right there by Alaska. They needed that stop to, you know, gather themselves. I mean, they will not have... Oh,
a penalty, and this will be interesting. It's a long way to the first down marker. Let's take a listen. That is going to be a foul on Alaska for encroachment. They will move them a little closer. I don't think it gives them the automatic first down, Ramos. If it does... No, it does not. Fourth and six. I was going to say, if so, no, yeah. Alaska got robbed.
No, yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, but no, I mean... Fortunately for them, that doesn't even put them in field goal range as far as Sioux Falls go. And it could be a blessing in disguise because now you have to punt the ball at the 36 and, you know, the punter doesn't have enough space
to maneuver. It might go into the end zone here. You're right, Ramos. It might be more negative or more positive than it was negative. Oh, Alaska almost got to that one. Instead, the kick is away. It will bounce at the 9, bounce at the 3. Oh, what a defensive play! And he kept it out of the end zone! Unbelievable! Nice job by Sioux Falls. Hashtag clip that. It was a great play by Bobby Carpenter, the cornerback.
Or maybe not. I mean, they needed those 5 yards, it seems.
Yeah, it was angled towards the sidelines, but still, Alaska is backed up. The question is, can Sioux Falls do anything about it? 8:44 left to go in the third, still 10 all. Sioux Falls drive stalled out. Now let's see what Alaska can do. The handoff there. It goes nowhere. Jason Williams gets a yard. There's a look at the running back to fullback comparison between Sioux Falls and Alaska, and so far it's a Colin Hart show.
It is, and this is a Colin Hart show, and as far as Alaska goes, there's not been a guy, I mean, Optimus Klein in the first quarter, but there's really not been a guy who has, like, really shine in this game on offense.
Cochran fires, tipped away, incomplete at the last second. It was an incredible play by the Sparrows. And Ramos, it was the guy you talked about earlier, Zeno Sika, the former star player for the Sparrows, sticking around as a veteran.
Yeah, definitely. And this is a player who has been in this team a long time. And, you know, he was the number one corner at one point, but now with a new fresh talent, he's been put in the slot with some, you know, he's a veteran, so he now has another role.
Play action there to Merrill. Will not pick up the first down. Alaska there struggles to pick up a first down on third down. They're usually pretty good at that. Well, we've been harping about how good Alaska is at it, Ramos. They're number one in the league at 68%, but if you flip sides of the field, Sioux Falls is actually the second best team at 59%. So a very important down is third down in this game, and really that's been the tale of the tape. The teams that convert the third downs have scored. The teams that have struggled end up punting.
Yeah, and speaking about punting, right here, Sioux Falls will have really terrific field position.
A.J. Levy will get it right to midfield, so they'll start in no man's land. Julian Tyree will bring the offense back out, 14 of 21 for 180 yards today for him. His favorite target is A.J. Warren, number 15, 55 yards for that man there.
Yeah, and now with the ball at midfield, you have a lot of, you know, plays to call here. I mean, you can run the ball, you can pass the ball. Basically, you're in no man's land. You know, it's going to be difficult to predict.
Check down to Hart. Hart puts a man down and picks up six. And right in front of him blocking was number 11, Sean Harrelson. Haven't called his name much tonight. One target for him, didn't get to haul it in. He's been working on the outside against Evan Carroll, the four-year man playing all his time here in Alaska. Carroll has been doing a nice job of locking down Sean.
Yeah, he has, and now with a second and four, look at all the players in the front.
Tyree pressured, and he can't get rid of it. He's going to go down at the 49. That one just looked like it was inevitable.
Yeah, it really was, and I'm surprised that, you know, him being a veteran quarterback didn't try to probably go to the left and buy a little bit more time. It just seemed that he just stood up there and waited for it, so it could be crucial. I mean, again, you know, Sioux Falls is really, really good converting the third downs, as you were saying, but still, you know, third and eight, this is man-to-man press coverage. Let's see if they can do a crossing route as they do sometimes.
Tyree to throw, fires on the corner route, one-handed catch. Can he get the sticks? No, he's a yard short. Riley Porter made the grab but could not turn upfield. It's an open field tackle by the non-contract I.B. Lurkin, 6'1".
Man, what do you do? I mean, your punter just pinned the ball deep at the 6-yard line.
I give it to Hart, right up the gut.
Yeah, me too, up the gut, like right behind the center.
They will throw Tyree into pressure. He's sacked. Alaska's going to take the ball back. Now two turnovers on downs. It's Gerald Thomas.
What a play by the Alaska coverage. Look at that. Nobody's open, and there's no other option for Julian Tyree other than taking the sack. I mean, if you throw the ball out of bounds and you don't lose yards, that's a better choice. But still, I mean, that's a terrific job by Alaska. And, you know, when you face the champions and you cannot convert and you give them great field position like this time, it really could cost you the game.
Well, it cost him 6 yards there on first down. Jason Williams making them pay. Alaska, like you said, the defending champions coming out of season 10 here in season 11. They have not lost since the regular season in season 10, and they are trying to push their way back into the championship game. They'll be a game closer if they can beat Sioux Falls today.
Yeah, they really will.
Twins out, and they got wide open room there. They could run a 5-yard out route and get it. And that's what they do. Oh, but it's almost taken away. AJ Levy read it like a book in a library, but could not wrap his hands around it. There is a flag, though.
Yeah, that's going to be an offsides.
And a killer play for Sioux Falls, considering that, Ramos, they almost had the pick six going the other way for a touchdown.
Yeah, it really is. Obviously, it would have been back, but, you know, that's two tough breaks for Sioux Falls Bears. Number one, getting the offsides, most importantly, and then number two, not able to come away with the INT. And even if that's not a pick six, that's scoring range already. So, you know, that's instead as a first down again for Alaska.
The Jack 3D Gamer with 1,000 bits. That moves him up to second on the leaderboard. Let's see if we can take off Eric Vincent, who's at the top. Oh! Oh, it's picked off! Sioux Falls takes it away. An unbelievable interception right after they gave up free yardage. They get it back the other way. It's Jay Ringgold, the rookie cornerback.
Wow, what a play. And, you know, reading this one all the way. I mean, that's textbook coverage, reading the play, looking at the receiver, then looking at the quarterback, knowing exactly what they're going to do, and getting the interception.
Ramos, Alaska coming into the game was 18th in the SFL in turnover differential. They were at minus 6. They're at minus 3 today, and Sioux Falls is trying to make them pay. Check down there, and they will get to midfield. A 6-yard pickup for the fullback, Ashley Anderson.
You know, and Ashley Anderson, you know, speaking about players who were in this team as contracted players, Ashley Anderson was the running back, so he has some wheels. Now he's a veteran, you know, he has moved to fullback, but he has some wheels still.
Tyree to throw, checks down to Hart off the right side with a blocker in front of him. He's going to outrun the blocker. Colin Hart does it on his own to the 31, well into Alaska Storm territory, right on the edge of field goal range.
And that just might be field goal range. Look at
it's
that.
Close.
Again, open space for Colin Hart to maneuver. And this is something that, you know, Alaska has been lights out stopping the middle of the field and, you know, the runs to the inside, but they have not been able to stop the edges consistently. Sometimes on some runs they have, but when they dump it, like, on a screen pass or, like, you know, the type of passes to the flat, they have been unable to stop them.
Colin Hart, 17 touches today, 128 yards, and a touchdown. Tyree fires here on the outside to the first down marker, and he's got it. Nice completion there. That's number 18 for Sioux Falls. Turain James, 6 foot, 200 pounds, excuse me, with a first down to the 20.
And again, a pass to the flat, and it was not to the running back, but it was to the wide. And again, open space, breaks the tackle, and gets a first down, gets in the red zone.
Tyree to throw. He will pump once. Pressured and sacked. And the problem is he hasn't been able to find Hart on all of those plays. Alaska has read it pretty well. And then the pressure gets to Tyree, and he's going to lose 5 there.
Now puts the ball at 2nd and 15, the ball at the 25-yard line. And, you know, being Sioux Falls, you have to think that Colin Hart right now is a little bit gassed. I mean, this has been a drive with a few plays. They've been throwing the ball to him, so he has to be a little bit tired.
Tyree wants it all. End zone tipped up and incomplete. He was looking to target Sean Harrelson, and boy, that would have been a catch. It would have been his first one of the day, and it would have gone for a touchdown. Only the second time they've targeted him.
That was so close from being intercepted, and it would have been a killer for Sioux Falls, who is now in scoring range and cannot afford to come away empty in this drive. So, honestly, in 3rd and 13, you have to play the probability game. You know, it's like,
yep.
How probable it is for us to get a first down? We might just dump it short and get the field goal.
Tyree wings it into the end zone! Touchdown,
wow.
Sean Harrelson! Unbelievable scenes! Hashtag clip it! That's 6 for the Sparrows!
What do I know, right?
I want you to watch this throw. That was incredible.
That's unbelievable.
He was hit as he threw, and Harrelson gets his first catch of the day.
Not only that, but it seems like it was kind of like a sidearm throw, like a three-quarters throw. I mean,
yeah.
it was a wobble.
Was
so, yeah, and it was weird. It was weird looking. You know, when it came away from his arm, it was like, man, that's going to get intercepted. Like, there's going to be a center fielder going to chase him, but it didn't happen. And what a play by Sioux Falls. they get in the lead for the first time in the ballgame.
Turnovers into points here. They're going to try and add the extra point. It is up and good. We'll step aside. Sioux Falls is on top, 17-10. We'll be right back on the SFL Network, brought to you by APM Music. Follow the SFL on Twitter at SimulationFL, on Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube and Twitch channels. You're already here, right? Might as well stay tuned. Get league updates on your phone while browsing the internet, and make sure you never miss a live broadcast. Thank you for supporting the SFL. Short kick. The return will come out across the 30. You can use the hashtag SFL playoffs on Twitter. Get a free retweet from me. It'll probably be after the game, but I might be able to check it here in a minute. Hashtag SFL playoffs on Twitter. Tell your friends. Get as many people in here as you can. We are trying to fill up the league for the draft, which is coming in the offseason. And we've got some exciting new prospects here in the chat as well. RudeDogs22, I believe that's a new name. So a lot of new guys coming in and trying to earn their spot. Jason Williams sure has earned his spot, and he picks up four there to the 36.
Yeah, and Jason Williams has not been involved in the passing game, which I'm a little bit surprised. You know, they not only throw it to the flats, but they put him as a wide receiver, and they throw like the slant routes and post routes and corner routes with him. And I'm kind of surprised they've not, try to find him a little bit more in the passing game.
Cochran, corner route, wide open down the sideline. Is anyone going to catch him? Jeff Como gets to the 31, and that was a blown coverage from Sioux Falls, and Alaska is the beneficiary.
What a throw, and what a recognition on the play. That was a corner route, and it looked kind of like a fade route or something like that, because it didn't go all the way to the corner. It was just kind of like a fade or something. And he was completely wide open. It was a strange-looking play, but it worked perfectly for Alaska, who is right now in scoring position.
Cochran chucks another one. That one is Robert Merrill. He picks up 9. Some other new names in the chat. Biz Woofer, along with the Dead Knight, 57. PGTUKOL. So lots of new names, Ramos. But the old names are getting it done here for Alaska. Robert Merrill, a nice catch there.
Yeah, nice catch and a good job by the defense preventing him from going into the first down as well. Now we see a 4-3 defense. I would like to see a run up the gut here for Alaska.
Two split backs here. 4-3 look out of the Sparrows. Handoff wide open up the middle. A nice run, and A.J. Levy has to clean it up. Jason Williams was all over that one, and it's first and goal for the Alaska Storm.
Yeah, and Jason Williams gets that one easily. Second down and one. And you have to give the ball to the big man up the gut. And, I mean, there's nobody touching him in like 10 yards after he gets past the first down marker. A great job by the offensive line.
Back and forth we go. 17-10, a minute and 40 and ticking left to go here in the third quarter. Andy Hamilton along with Ramos Lynn. Nathan Blake is on stats for our quarterfinal game here between Alaska and Sioux Falls. Handoff, Williams, one man to beat, he can't do it. Sioux Falls puts him to the turf. I thought he was going in, Ramos.
Me too. Just for 1 second, I thought he was going to run over the last defender and get in. But, you know, Sioux Falls does the job and prevents him to go in the paint, so now they can do another goal line stand.
3-4 look out of Sioux Falls. That's unique. The corners are up, looking like they might bump. 2 in the backfield for Ron Cochran, who will give it to Williams up the middle, and he is stuffed like a turkey in November.
Yeah, he is, and, you know, with 3 straight carries, obviously Sioux Falls was waiting for it, and with 3rd and goal, the ball at the 2-yard line, you know, the field has shrunk on you, so you cannot maneuver as far as the wide receiver goes, doing like, you know, running routes, crossing routes. So let's see what they do, and let's see if they keep it short.
Cochran to throw, plenty of time, now pressured, dumps off to Williams, and Jason Williams is in! Touchdown, Alaska, the Storm, pull within 1!
Wow, what a great job by the offensive line of Alaska, just giving Ron Cochran all day to throw. And, you know, obviously all the credit in the world for Jason Williams to get in the end zone, but that's really poor coverage by the corner who had the responsibility on him. He was not close enough, off of him, So he allowed him to go inside and get in the end zone.
Well, Cochran had a delayed blitz from a defensive back, and he was under a lot of pressure there. Was luckily able to get it off. And with 28 seconds left to go here in the third, Ramos, this kick has now tied the game at 17.
17-17, you have a great player returning kicks right now. Let's see if this is the last score before the third quarter is over.
Alaska has been in a lot of close games. Some recent ones that come to mind was Las Vegas. The Fury almost were were a team that was able to knock off Alaska. Vancouver also had an opportunity earlier in the season, and I'm sure the chat will let me know if I miss a team here. Kick is away. Levy is 5 yards deep and will bring it out. Across the 15, pushes the blocker out of the way and gets smashed.
Wow. Who was that?
I could not even see a number. It was a blur.
Yeah, I mean, it was just 1 second he was running and the other second he was in the ground. It was a great coverage right there by Alaska. So, you know, third down, only 24 seconds to go. Sioux Falls, I mean, you want to get some, time of possession here and just kind of secure the ball and move the ball methodically down the field.
Jason Tyree, threads the needle to Sean Harrelson. Harrelson, only his second catch. He's coming alive late in this game.
That's a great job by Julian Tyree on throwing the ball, and that's even a better job of getting open by Harrelson. And, you know, that's a perfectly timed throw. If you throw it just half a second earlier, Carroll deflects it. If you throw it a second late, the safety picks it off. So that was a great job on timing.
11 minutes on the clock. It's the end of the third quarter. Twitch chat, get your fours up. We got 11 minutes to play, and we're all knotted up at 17 on the SFL Network. Brought to you by APM Music. It's the quarterfinals. Four quarter, 11 minutes to go to decide who moves on and who goes home to their mama. Three receivers split out for Tyree with Colin Hart alone in the backfield. Tyree, short drop, checks down to Hart. Hart with some room on the right-hand side, and DJ Majesty closes down on him at the 40.
That's a great play by Sioux Falls. That could have been like a 5-yard sack, and instead Colin Hart goes for 7 yards and puts the ball in a second and short. Alex Dominguez, though, with 2 sacks and putting some pressure on the QB, it's not long enough for him to get another sack, I guess.
We got 83 viewers on Twitch. Get your friends in here. Pull that number up. Hand off Hart. Hart pushes a man down. First down to the 47. Sioux Falls is driving.
That was pretty much the same play that Alaska did in the previous drive. Jason Williams got completely untouched for like 15 yards. Very similar play. Great job by the right guard on opening the space as well as the tight end. And Colin Hart had about 8 yards between him and the first defender and getting closer to now midfield.
From the 47, 10 minutes to go and ticking. Pressure is mounting here at the eye. The fans are getting nervous. Tyree, 7-step drop, fires, caught, first down. Sean Harrelson got it.
That's another great throw. I mean, that's pinpoint accuracy. If you throw the ball just a little bit behind them, that could have been intercepted. So he had to throw the ball on that spot. He did and got another first down.
Two backs in the backfield again. Alaska putting a lot of men on that line. It looks like they're playing bump on the top of the screen with Harrelson. Handoff Hart. Hart is dropped. Alaska has been all over those power rushes. They've had more success when they toss it out to Hart on the outside.
Yeah, and you know, when they toss it to the outside, it seems that Alaska's trying to get some pressure on the inside and kind of stop the middle of the field. So when they've gone to the outside, it's worked. I would like to see again going to the far side of the field, going to the right with Colin Hart.
Let's
on a throw.
See what they do here. 9 minutes to go. Sioux Falls making sure to bleed this clock. They will throw out to Hart with blocker in front of him, and he will not get past the first wave, but he does pick up a nice 6 yards there to make it 3rd and 5. It's a little bit more manageable, Ramos, but now we get into that question of, are you going to throw or pass here?
Yeah, I think they have to throw the ball now, not with to Colin Hart. If you saw that play, looked a little bit tired. You know, he did not look like 100%. He looked like at 60%. And, you know, he's not on the field, so they are trying to give him a breather here, and let's see if they can convert.
Tyree, quick throw. Oh, it was hit at the last second. And by who else but DJ Majesty gets a hand to it and makes one of the critical plays in this game.
Yeah, and he hit it, and then Hearn had it in his hands as well. But because the ball was deflected, there was no chance for Hearn to react to the ball quickly enough. Now they have to punt. Sioux Falls has, with Max Moholt, who has been here again for many seasons now, a veteran. So let's see how he does now going in favor of the win.
They will try and trust their defense with 8.5 minutes to play. Kick is away. Alaska looking to protect the return man. This one is going to bounce at the 4 and into the end zone. They cannot stop that one. And Ron Cochran will have 80 yards between him and the goal line.
You know, and Sioux Falls, what they have to do right now is that they have lacked in this game a little bit of a pass rush here in the second half, I think. It seems that Ron Cochran has had some time to throw the ball. So if they could put in some pressure on the QB, I think that could help it mightily. So let's see if they can do it.
Press look out of the Sparrows. They will back out of it. Check down there to Nordellis out of the backfield. Nordellis has some room, and Nordellis is down to the 38. Can you believe it, Ramos? Just when Sioux Falls thinks they have all of the stars covered, Alaska checks down to a non-contract role player who's doing his job.
And that play went for 18 yards, and you can credit 9 to Nordellis and 9 to Robert Merrill for the incredible block he did on the outside. If it wasn't for that block, the defender tackles him before he gets to the first down marker. So that was a beautiful job by number 18 on the outside. And, you know, Alaska with an 18-yard gain, that's what they do. You know, those big chunk plays that are so hard to stop.
Cochran to throw, pressured, and he's going to lose yardage. Loss of 7. Tyrone McGee is in there and lays the sack on him. And I was just about to say, what can the Sparrows do? Well, a sack will help.
Yeah, you know, before this drive, I said, you know, Sioux Falls needs to put some pressure on the QB. They did it that time. 2nd and 17, and this is a time where this safeties can eat. You know, A.J. Levy already has a pick, so, you know, they will be looking for that ball. Let's see if they can get an interception here.
Cochran fires deep right side. Caught! Oh, down wow. The right-hand sideline! It's Jeff Kobo, and he's down to the 27. Someone ate Ramos, but it was not the Sparrows' defense. It was a buffet for the Storm.
Yeah, what a play right there on the outside, and that was well covered. I mean, this is not bad coverage at all. Look at that. A.J. Levy's right there, but he just gets behind the player instead of in front of the player. Jeff Como, with his big 6'6 range, goes up and gets it. And again, you know, all of a sudden, Alaska from a sack to now being in scoring range.
Three receivers split out for Cochran, lone man in the backfield. 5 in the box for Sioux Falls. They are playing the pass. Cochran to throw. Pressured. Gonna fire it out, and that one is caught, and they will pick up 7. It's a nice completion there. That is, I believe, Jason Julian, the tight end. And I tell you what, Ramos, Optimus Klein has gone quiet in this game.
He really has. Since the first quarter where he got that big throw, like the big catch and everything, it's been really a lot of even like role players getting in the action, or Dallas and
yep.
and players like that. So, but it's a testament to the corners of
Jason Williams, a first down run to the 15. But as you were saying, Ramos, it's really about these non-contract players who have been getting it done for Alaska. But a star there comes out of the woodwork and makes it 1st and 10.
You know, with a 15, you have to play that smart. I mean, it's going to be 6 minutes left. So 1st and 10, the ball at the 15. I will give the ball to Nordellis. I mean, you again, looking, you know, speaking about the non-contracted players, give the ball to Nordellis and see what he can do.
Play action. Cochran fires outside. That one is hauled in. And I believe that is our man who we were looking for, Optimus Klein. He said in the chat he likes watching his teammate eat. Well, they threw him some scraps there, and he picks up 7.
Yep. And with a 2nd and 3... Now, you know, this really makes things a little bit easier. They gave Jason Williams a breather on the last play. Let's see if he's not on the field this time either. But now changing the play, maybe it's going to be an out route to Robert Merrill here. Look at, you know, inside leverage by the corners.
Cochran changes the play. Three receivers split out. Cochran to throw, and that is caught for the touchdown. Optimus Klein is in, and Alaska adds and retakes the lead. Touchdown, Storm.
And I'm not sure if it was Jeff Como who that one was, but he almost stole the ball out of Optimus Klein. You know, it was Jeff Como. He put some hands on it up, and he wanted to get the ball, but he was not going his direction. So. Even though, I mean, that's a beautiful drive here by Alaska. Textbook drive, champion drive, you know, getting the ball at 20-yard line and boom, 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 scoring a touchdown, getting in the paint. And now they will have a 7-point lead, extra point pending.
23-17. Alaska has retaken the lead at home. Kick from Brad Bretchett is up and good. We will step aside and be right back on the SFL Network. Brought to you by APM Music.
Join the world's fastest growing sim football community by jumping onto our Discord server. Use the Discord command in chat to keep up with schedules, news, notes, announcements, and polls. Jump off the sidelines and into the action here where we're loading legends at the SFL.
Well, the return by A.J. Levy will be out to the 28. 5:11 to go, all three timeouts for Sioux Falls. Ramos, Julian Tyree has played well. The question is, has he played well enough to bring this team back?
Well, everything will be decided in this drive. I mean, if Julian Tyree can put up a drive just like Ron Cochran did a few moments ago, I mean, this is going to be huge for Sioux Falls.
Tyree, first throw, incomplete, a wobbler there, dangerous throw as he got hit. Ron Cochran gave 100 bits for the score, want to make sure we get his shout-out. But an incompletion from Tyree there on first down does not bode well for Sioux Falls.
And I'm kind of surprised that was not called for a PI or some kind of illegal contact. I'm not sure if the ball was tipped, but I think that the Alaska defender just tackled the wide receiver. Maybe it was a uncatchable ball. I'm not sure.
Four split out for Tyree. He's going to throw. Deep drop. Fires across the middle. That's a completion for a first down to the 45. It's A.J. Warren who pops back up after a stellar first half.
And that's a great route right there by A.J. Warren going in just a quick in route. Good protection by the offensive line again. And, you know, that's a great throw and a big first down getting the ball into midfield. Well, just behind midfield, sorry.
First and 10 from the 45, 3-3 look with an extra man in the box for Alaska. They bring three. Tyree fires, nearly taken away. A.J. Warren hauls it in, picks up four to midfield. Clock continues to roll. Is this what Sioux Falls wants to do, or are they going to run out of time, Ramos?
Yeah, I mean, they still have some time. They have three timeouts. The ball's at midfield. I agree with the play call here, to be honest with you. I have a lot to maneuver. And you don't want to throw an interception, so I agree with the play call. I think this is a good drive so far for Julian Tyree.
Alaska playing off. They will throw again, and Sean Harrelson has plenty of room to haul that one into the 39. They're in Storm territory, and again, the clock will roll. We're going to be under 4 minutes at the time of the next snap.
Well, the 39 now is going to be a matter of, you know, using your time to your disposal. You have three timeouts. You don't want to rush it, but you don't want to take things too slow. I mean, I think that the pace that they have right now is what is working so far.
Check down Colin Hart off the right side, and he picks up a nice 8-yard gain, does a good job of staying in bounds, getting to the 31. Colin Hart tonight, that is his 22nd touch over 150 yards and one touchdown for him.
Yep, and you know, with a second and two here, the playbook is really open. I would like for them to go run into the inside. Up the
second and two, they will give to Hart off the right side, and he is clobbered. Alaska read that one real well. Coming up to make the play was number 30. That is Ramel Hernandez, the 6'3", 210, starting strong safety.
Yeah, you know, he's the starting strong safety. He's been here for a couple seasons, and he's really, really solid. I mean, he's been benefited from the experience of the defensive backs of the last.
Third and three, and Tyree goes down. Who else, Ramos, the MVP candidate? Big Sexy will drop him to the 38. It'll be fourth and nine, and it's decision time for the Sparrows.
And that's just a really, really poor awareness for Julius. I mean, he had a player on the near side completely wide open. Like, if he throws the ball, there's no way that's not a completion. But kudos to Alaska and Alex Dominguez getting in the backfield and making the sack.
Here we go, fourth and nine. This is your ball game. Tyree to throw. He fires left side, tipped up, incomplete. Alaska makes the play. They were looking for Sean Harrelson, and the Storm take over. It's not over yet, Ramos, but it sure isn't looking good for Sioux Falls.
Yep, doesn't look good for Sioux Falls, and it's been a fact of, you know, Alaska here in the clutch coming away with a place in the last 3 minutes of the game, and Sioux Falls unable to make a stop on defense and now unable to get a fourth down. Now it's going to be Alaska. They need two first downs, and I think that with two first downs, they could really seal this game. But knowing them, I would not be surprised if they throw the ball 50 yards and get another score.
Yeah, that's the problem. They don't have this rush offense. They come in with the 19th best rushing offense in the league. They give it to Williams. Shut down. Sioux Falls was all over it. Only 60 yards for Williams tonight. So the question is, he's got 9 yards between him and the first down marker. We're at the two-minute warning. It's the SFL Network brought to you by APM Music. Alaska clings to a seven-point lead. They have the ball, trying to put it away here at home. Sioux Falls trying to get back into this one. All right, Ramos, timeouts will come if Sioux Falls can get a stop. Alaska needs 9 yards to put this thing into a real frenzy. Three receivers split out. Cochran in the shotgun with one man to his left. Four linemen down for Sioux Falls. They will bring the four. Play action, throw. Cochran, first down to the 49, and Sioux Falls is forced to take their first timeout with a minute and 56 left.
Yeah, you have to think that Alaska will, from here on out, obviously try to get the field this game. And I will say that in first down, at least, you do have to run the ball with Jason Williams, force Sioux Falls to call a timeout. Even if it's just like a no-yard play or two-yard play, I think that you need to put the ball on the ground and force the Sparrows to call another timeout.
Steven at large, 100 bits for 100 viewers. I love it. Hand off Williams, just as you predicted, Ramos. But he is stuffed. Nick Fargo all over that one, trying to get a big stop for his Sparrows. It'll be second and 11. Clock is stopped again.
Yeah, but if you're Alaska, I mean, you can live with it. I mean, it's like we lost a yard, but now Sioux Falls has just one timeout left. And, we still have two more chances to get a first down. So, if I know Alaska now, they will try to throw the ball, probably like a slant route or something like they love to do.
Three receivers split out, two in the backfield. They give it to Williams again up the gut, and he will be brought down third and six. Clock is stopped for the final time. Sioux Falls burns their last timeout. So with third and six, 6 yards between them and the sticks, Alaska will have one more opportunity to put this game to bed in front of the home crowd.
Third and six, what do you do? Do you run? Well, look, it's shotgun. It's shotgun. I say they run the corner route and they get a touchdown because why not? It's a last.
Cochran to throw. He will fire on the out route. It is incomplete! Incomplete! Wow. Optimus Klein was out of bounds, and Sioux Falls is going to get the ball back. And Ramos, not only that, the clock stops with a minute 45.
Yeah, the clock stops with a minute and 45 seconds, and wow, what do you do here?
He had him.
Yeah. I mean, obviously you have to punt. You know, you cannot go for it right here. But, you know, if you're Alaska on defense to stop Sioux Falls, do you kind of play prevent? Because 1 minute and 40 seconds is not too short. I mean, you still have
plenty
some time if you're Sioux Falls. Yeah, I mean, do you play some prevent?
Oh, a fair catch by A.J. Levy. He's not giving them anything. It's going to be 89 yards between them and the end zone, Ramos. They need to get there.
Yep, they need 89 yards. And, you know, Sioux Falls, they do have the talent. I mean, they do have the receivers. They have A.J. Warren. They have Craig Hearn. They have the pieces to go down the field and strike quickly. But the Alaska defense is very, very stingy as well.
Tyree on first down will throw the out route. That is caught by Warren. He is out of bounds at the 16. And those are the type of plays they need. And Ramos, Alaska backed way off and gave Sioux Falls that yardage. If you're Max Paul, are you pulling those corners up or are you letting them play back?
Honestly, I put him back. I mean, this is a very dangerous Sioux Falls receiving team. I mean, this is a receiving squad that has a lot of speed. Sean Harrison, A.J. Warren, they can run. And you don't want, the last thing that you want is for them to get behind you.
Four receivers split out for Tyree. Fires again, this time in the field of play. It's off the back of a defender. It'll be incomplete. Third and five with 92 seconds to play. And I think if you're Sioux Falls, you almost wanted that one to be incomplete.
Yeah, you know, I think that Julian Tyree just threw it to the incorrect guy. I mean, there were three players running a similar route. And if he throws the ball to any one of the other two, I think that's a completion, but he threw the ball to the outmost receiver, and it didn't work.
Tyree, under pressure, checks down outside. Colin Hart threw one, and he gets out of bounds, and the first down. What a play. Colin Hart trying to give the Alaska Storm cardiac arrest.
Yeah, and that's a beautiful play. Not only gets the first down, which was the thing, but he gets the bonus, dragging a defender to the sidelines. I mean, he just fought for the sideline.
Unbelievable scenes here in Alaska. Anchorage, Alaska, it's cloudy, 48 degrees, just past 7 p.m., or just getting near 7 p.m. here local time, and Julian Tyree trying to lead the drive of his life. Throwing here, it's caught across the middle, and now Sioux Falls has to hurry up. Craig Hearn to the 31.
And you know, now it's when the time is running out on you, and you have all of those slant routes.
Tyree to throw again, another slant route. That one's caught to the 40. They're going to hurry up again, Ramos, and this could spell danger if they don't have an out route.
Yeah, I mean, it seems that they are stuck on these slant routes, so Alaska will allow those.
Throwing deep. That one's tipped up. Oh, it's incomplete. Alaska had an opportunity to end it right there. They could not wrap their hands around it. Ryan Tobin, the second-year man, got a hand to it.
And that's literally the best thing that could happen to Sioux Falls.
Right.
Even if that's a completion, it's a bad thing because the clock keeps moving. They were stuck on that play.
Uh-huh.
So it was a good luck to have it incomplete and just regroup and get another play in.
57 seconds left. Tyree, seven-step drop, fires on the out route. That one is caught, and going towards the sideline, he got out of bounds. Nice job by Riley Porter, the rookie, with the awareness to get to the sideline.
Yeah, great job going on a great route to the outside, gets the catch, breaks the tackle, and again, fights for the sideline. You can see how the safety tried to put him in bounds, and he just fought for that sideline.
Let's everyone take a deep breath. Deep breath here for everyone here,
does
not
that
only
exist?
Myself. I need it. I don't know if the chat needs it, but I need it. Jason said he's been standing all game. I hope he doesn't collapse over there. Tyree to throw again. Checks out to Colin Hart out of the backfield. Blocker in front of him. He gets out of bounds there at the 39. Now down to 46 seconds. There's a look at Colin Hart's numbers.
Whatever happens in this drive, whether Sioux Falls scores or they get stalled, I mean, this is a great drive. I mean, they not only have been able to get the first downs, but consistently get out of bounds to stop the clock. I mean, they have no timeouts left, so it is crucial from that to get out of bounds on every single play.
3-3 look out of Alaska. Three receivers to the top of the formation here for Sioux Falls. Tyree will throw, checks it down to Hart off the right side. Hart tackled in bounds, and now they're going to have to go hurry up again. It's third and five. They need the first down here, but they also need to stop the clock.
Now, do they have another play, or they're going to throw the ball to...
Tyree pressured, fires in the middle of the field. It's fourth and one. They got to go hurry up here. They just need the yard. Sean Harrelson, the completion to the 36.
And this is the game.
19, 18. Tyree taking his time. 16, 15, 14. Why hasn't he snapped the ball? Tyree now will snap it with 12. Going to throw, fires, incomplete. There is a flag.
Oh man, that's gonna be on Sioux Falls. It hit the head of the offman.
Two fouls.
Okay.
They're gonna go ineligible on Sioux Falls. And intentional.
And roughing the passer.
Roughing the passer. Unbelievable. They're going to offset and replay fourth down. Oh, no. I've seen it all.
Man. I mean, now Sioux Falls.
9 seconds.
Yeah. Now, what do you do? I mean, you have 9 seconds. Do you throw the ball short to the outside and get another play to the zone, or you go for it right now? I mean, you have 9 seconds.
It's tough. They're going to line him up and go for it. Tyree's in the shotgun.
Well,
three.
This is the game.
Three on the line for Alaska. Pressure coming. Tyree stands in the pocket, well protected, now moves. Fires deep down into the end zone. It's out of the back. 1 second on the clock. Oh! Was that fourth down?
It was fourth down. That was the game, and Alaska's going to. You know, that's what I was saying. You know, do you throw the ball short and get that 1 yard to give you a fresh set of downs with one more play to go, or you just go for it one time and just one shot?
Well, the throw was too strong. He had his man short, but he just threw it too deep.
It was too far. Yeah, it was too far. You know, he did not give it a fair shot to his receivers to fight for the ball. And, you know, now it's congratulating Alaska for another big-time win, and they move on. So, wow, what a game.
One kneel down will do it. 1,200 bits from the Brown Knight. Make sure you get your bits in for next season. But in this season, Alaska moves on 24-17, defeating the Sparrows for the third time this season. Houston awaits them on the other side of the semifinals with a trip to the championship on the line. Four teams remain. Only two will get into the championship. Make sure to stick with us on the SFL Network, brought to you by APM Music. If you're not in the Discord, get there. For Ramos Lynn, Andy Hamilton, along with Nathan Blake on stats, this has been the SFL's presentation of the quarterfinals on Twitch.